Hello everyone, how are you? Fine, thank you. Well, in today's class, we are going to discuss about a poem. This poem is based on the difference between a bird and a poetry, as well as what are the similarities between a bird and a poem. Children, this poem has been composed by a Japanese poet, and that is Naoshi Koriyama. Naoshi Koriyama has well described this poem. This poem has been parted into three paragraphs, and these three paragraphs has got some central idea of the poem. The central idea of the poem is about the patience and consistency. If a human being is having a patience and consistency, he can do very well in his life. Our life is just like a flower which develops equally like a bud. A bud like a water lily. In the same way, our life also blooms like a flower. We enjoy our life, admires it. But when we have patience, we are able to make our life, its happiness, from a bud to a blooming flower. As you can see in the screen, that in the first you find a bud, gradually gradually our life turns from a bud to a flower. Okay, so my main motto is to say that our life is just like a bud. So here we are going to have some description about the poem. This poem is divided into three paragraphs. These all three paragraphs has what? Has a clear development of a bird into a blooming flower, as a poetry develops from the beginning, and when it develops, we read again, again, and again, we come to see its real nature. Children, you must be watching in the screen how a bud is gradually developing, blooming, enjoying the natural beauty, and at last turned into a beautiful water lily. Okay, so here we are going to start. First of all, I will read this poem for you. The first one, stanza, is just like that, as you can see in the screen. One is amazed by a water lily unfolding with each passing day, taking on a richer color and new dimensions. Means to say, if somebody watches a water lily, it appears normal, but when gradually some watches it again and again and again, it takes new dimensions and become rich in color. Children, in this poetry, the poet has used a central metaphor. Central metaphor is that kind of metaphor in which an inanimate object is compared to other one in the entire poem. Now, the second stanza. One is not amazed at the first glance by a poem which is as tight closed as a tiny bud. That means to say, if we read the poem for the first time, we are unable to understand its entire meaning. In the same way, as we see a water lily's bud for the first time, it is tightly closed. So when we read a poem very in the first time, we come to know about what? About it is not revealing its entire meaning. We are unable to understand its deep meaning. Okay. And that's why in the first glance of the poem, we are unable to understand it. Now, come to the last stanza. Yet one is surprised to see the poem gradually unfolding, revealing its rich inner self as one reads it again and over again. In the last poetry, in the last stanza of this poem, we come to know that when we read the poem again and again and again, we come to know its real meaning. What is the theme of the poem? We read again and again and again as a bird. So I hope you must have got this poem. Thank you for today's class. Bye, children.